Hey, welcome to the brand new version 3 of Zubtitle. For me and the team here at Zubtitle, we're super excited to bring you this new update because we want to provide tools for you not only to add captions to your video, but also to optimize them for social media and even have the opportunity to repurpose them across multiple platforms. Don't worry, we still have all the features and tools that you've come to love, but we have added some exciting features, including a video trimming tool, as well as style templates to help you speed up your workflow. But if you've used the old version of the app, you'll probably notice some differences with the way things are laid out here. So I'm here to walk you step by step through this newly designed app and show you the new features so that you can get back to creating some awesome videos. So let's go ahead and start off here on the Zubtitle dashboard, which should look fairly familiar to you already. Let's go ahead and click Add New Video to create a new project. And now I do want to make mention that we actually do have the opportunity for you to have your subtitles in a different language other than English. And of course, you can change your default language at any moment. So you'll definitely want to do that before you upload your video. But of course, we're going to stick with English for today. Let me grab my video here and drag it in. So now what you'll notice here is something brand new, and this is our trimming feature. So while it's still uploading, you have the opportunity to trim your video down as much as you need to. So yeah, let's go ahead and do that real quick right now.
Other creators and keep your audience engaged.
Just gonna shrink the end here as well. And actually you can select this button here, which will actually play the last 5 seconds of the video to help you fine tune the ending of the video.
Progress bar or resize your video for social media.
And I'll also mention that if you need to fine tune the start and end of your trim, you can actually click here and enter a numeric value for the time. But yeah, it looks like if I scroll up here, it looks like the upload is complete and the transcription as well. So we can click here to continue. So here is the brand new Zubtitle editor. So first of all, you will see your captions and your headline here like you're used to. And right here, you'll see that this part is grayed out because this is part of the transcript that you've actually trimmed out. So if we scroll down, we can actually see where our video starts right here.
Quickly put subtitles on your videos at Zubtitle.
So just like before, you can go ahead and click to add a caption break, you can change the timing, and you can edit the text of the transcript. But what I do want to show you is our brand new style templates. If we go to the right pane here, you'll see that we actually have a bunch of pre-made templates that we've created for you to help you get started. So let's take a look at some of these real quick. And we've also added a very easy sorting filter. Depending on the aspect ratio of the video you're trying to create, you can sort by those videos, or you can also sort by the social platform that you want to create for. For instance, TikTok or Facebook. And let's try Instagram. And of course, you can also use this to filter down both ways. So let's say we want to post to Instagram Reels. Maybe we select the Instagram one and we select 9x16. And we see all the templates that we have available to us. So let's pick one of these to use as a starting point. Yeah, so I think I'm liking this one, but I do want to change up a few things about it. So first of all, I want to go ahead and edit my headline. We can actually do that right from the text editor back here. Here is my awesome headline. And so for many of you, this may be completely fine. You might be completely satisfied with the way this looks here. But let's say you want to maybe make a few edits to make it match your branding. Let's go into that in a little bit more detail. Let's go through to our textiles pane here, and we can actually edit both the headline and the caption text. So I'm just going to collapse these, and we can kind of start with one or the other. Let's start with the headline here. Let's maybe look for a different font that we can use. Let's try maybe this passion one. Yeah, that one's looking pretty cool. We can also edit other things like the font weight, the size. You can change the position of the headline. You can add an outline or a shadow, add some padding. But I think that's looking pretty good for our headline. Of course, we can turn it on and off like so if we want to. But let's move on to our captions here. And I actually want to do something a little bit different with the captions. Instead of having the text box completely transparent, we're actually going to kind of turn up the opacity here, and you can kind of start to see that it's white there. And if we make it all the way white, of course, it's going to disappear because our text is white. So let's quickly change our text color to something a little bit more visible. Maybe we'll use this blue here. That looks kind of nice. I think I'm going to go ahead and make this not full width. Maybe change the padding around a little bit. Yeah, that's looking pretty good. Maybe change the font weight just a bit. Yeah, there's a bunch of options that you have. Let's take a look at what that looks like.
You can quickly put subtitles on your videos at Zubtitle.com. It's totally free to sign up. So go ahead and, you know, film your video on your phone.
And I will make mention as well, if some of you actually like to edit your captions to where they all appear on one line, you can actually do that in two different ways. Obviously, you can do that right here from the caption editor, but we can also go back over here and select the text line, the max text line, change that to one. And of course, that will shrink the size of the captions if they are too long, but that's kind of where you might want to go back in here, maybe add a caption break to kind of make it the size that you want. And that'll help everything stay on one line for the duration of the video. So yeah, that's looking pretty good so far. There's a few more things we can do. After the text styles is looking good, we'll go down to canvas. And of course, we can change our video zoom. Let me kind of get to a different spot here. Yes, we can zoom in all the way, do something like that. I think we're going to keep it close to what it was, but I do want to change the background color. So let's change it to this blue color that we selected earlier. And of course, we can also go ahead and add a logo. Let's do that here. All right, so now we have our logo not only added to this project, but it will be saved in our library so we can actually use it in the future. So, you know, you can still click on it, move it around, drag it where you want to. Maybe I'll just make it a hair smaller than what we have here. Yeah, but that's looking pretty good. Next, we'll go back to our progress bar, and I think we'll maybe change just a little bit about this. Maybe we'll just give it a little bit more pop. Yeah, I think that little green color looks kind of nice. We can still click on it to drag it around or to resize it. And lastly, I want to show you that you can also go back here and change the aspect ratio in the resize pane. So of course, we may not want to do that because we've already selected the size we wanted in the templates pane. So we'll just go back to this. Awesome, so this is looking pretty good to me. But one last step we might want to do before we go ahead and download our video is actually save this template so we can use it in future videos and speed up our workflow as far as the styling goes. So let's go back to the templates pane and we can actually click here and do save as new. So we'll give our template a name. My awesome template. And another thing that you can do is add some social media tags here to kind of show which social media platform you're planning to post this on. So maybe we'll select Instagram and TikTok, and maybe we'll say YouTube for YouTube Shorts, and we'll click save. And so that way it will actually be saved here in my templates to use in the future. You see here, click away. And it's still saved. And it'll also show up in our filters here. If we go to TikTok, you'll see that it's there, Instagram. And of course, if we click LinkedIn, it will disappear. Now, let's say you actually want to make some changes to your template. Like, let's say we make our logo a little bit bigger here. You'll notice that it will actually create an unsaved draft here. So what we can do is either save it as a brand new template if we want to, or we can update the one we are currently working in. If we need to, we can change the name here, we can change our tags, but we'll just go ahead and click update. And now our template here is updated. And just two more things I want to show you before we go ahead and render and download. First of all, if you want to rename your project, you can go back over here and you can change the name of it if you'd like to. And also, if you weren't completely happy with your trim video, you can actually click here and go back and change the trim. And by the way, I forgot to mention this before, but this number down here will actually show you how long your video is. So if you need to get your video, say, down to maybe 1 minute, it'll kind of help you do that so that you can maybe post to a platform that only allows 1 minute videos. We'll go ahead and click save, and it's saved, showing the segment of the video that you're using here. And I think we're ready to go ahead and render and download. So that is it, and I really hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you have any additional questions, you can always reach out to us through our Subtitle chat. And if you have any suggestions for how we can improve or any features that you'd like to see us add in the future, please let us know that as well. Thank you so much for watching. If you're watching here on YouTube, be sure and subscribe and give this video a thumbs up. Thanks so much, and keep creating.